I've just placed the rear wall into position. Now all I've got to do is just screw the rear strengthening button into position. Once I've done that, I'll be lifting the main lintel up at the top there, and I'll show you how I do it. For this, I'm just using a 2.5-inch decking screws. Okay, so as it stands, this strengthening button here is attached to this main wall pillar. It's attached to this pillar, and this one. However, the bottom part of the foundation here is not attached to this yet. So what I'm going to do now is screw this base straight down foundation using 150mm by 7mm structural screws. There you go, 150mm long by 7mm. There you are, I'll just screw that section down after. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is put this top joist on, the top lintel, and it's not that heavy, so I can lift it up physically. The only thing I've had to do is put the sash clamp there, because I know the left hand side of the post is slightly warped, so it won't fit in exactly. So I'll lift this up, slide the left hand side one into position, then close this hash clamp and hopefully it should drop into here. Okay, I think what I'll do, I will screw the two centre posts into position first, then secure the two end posts. Okay, I'm not going to film that bit simply because the camera is on the ladder at the minute. I need the ladder just to screw those into position, but once it's all screwed into position, I will show you. So there you go, the back frame is now completed and secure. All level at the top, which is good to see. So, I'm going to start concentrating on the front wall panel now. Now, because it is going to be a Japanese tea house, I'm going to have a sliding door at the front there. So, I've been thinking about it. I could either do it at the same dimensions as the pillars around the walls for the sliding door, i.e. the same width as the middle section there. Or I'm going to do it double that size. So I'm just going to have a think about it. For the front two walls, left and right, all that I've done is cut a length of 4x4 down to about 652mm. Cut an R flap at the end where the sliding door will go and fit a pillar. The pillar is about 184cm if I remember, but I've measured them up against the other walls and now all that I've got to do is fit the lintel, the rafter, call it whatever you want, and I can tie all the four walls together. Let's try again. Okay, so let's cue them down. Got 100mm ones from these. Thank you. all I'll do now is just secure the sides. Clamp it into place. Do a starter roll on that one, it's a bit tight. drains the battery. The side and that's it. We'll do two starter drills, holes on this one, on the side. And I'll start the structure screws in and follow off with the power drill. And there we are. All I need to do now is just remove these, and I can fit the centering studs. But that'll be for another day. There we are. Until tomorrow, that's it. So that's the two front walls finished now, left and right. I put the supporting members in, as you can see. I haven't gone straight through to the two door frames. I've gone halfway through. So there's no need, only mitered the corner joint and not where the door frames are. So we've gone round about 40mm in. I think it looks a little bit more effective. So all I'm going to do now is put some battens in between the frames, so I can fit the sheet as and when the time is required. Okay, so that'll be the just the panelling basically, the battens for the panelling.